Hey, hello everyone. So in today's video, we are going to revise the topic genetics from the perspective of pathology, and I hope you all are also revising it with me. So let's start about the genetics. So first we have to know about some basic concepts of the genetics. So in basic concepts of genetics, the number of genes were, as we all know, that were 20,000 plus, and parts of a gene were include exon and intron. So exon is the coding region and intron were the non-coding regions, and the non-coding region covers the approximate 98.5% and coding region were approximate 1.5%, and the most commons were introns. So next one is the locus and allele. Locus means there is location of a gene on a chromosome, and allele means different forms of a gene. So here I give an example like p53 gene, where the location of the p53 gene is chromosome 17p. So locus is chromosome 17 on the p. P means short arm and q means long arm. Short arm, long arm, and there is a centromere also present in the chromosome, as we all know. So p53 gene, so gene is p53 and chromosome number is 17, and the location is on short arm, that is p. After that, the dominant and recessive. Dominants, like we represent it with capital letter A, and recessive we represent it with small letter a. So recessive allele will manifest only in the homozygous condition, and dominant allele will manifest in both homozygous plus heterozygous both condition. So here I wrote that dominant gene is represented in both homo and hetero condition, and recessive will manifest only in homogeneous condition. So remember this also. After that, homozygous and heterozygous. What do we mean by homozygous and heterozygous? Basically, homozygous means the same letters. Like if both are letters were in capital letter, or both letters were in small letters. So this is the this were the in the capital letter and these were in the small letter, so it is both are in homozygous condition. And heterozygous condition means they are in different, like one capital and one small letter. So this one, and in this dominant one is the A and recessive is the small a. After that we have codominance. Co means both, and dominance means dominant. So both dominant alleles manifest itself. Like example is AB blood group. So AB blood group is example of codominance. Remember it also, that AB blood group is codominance. After that we have pseudo dominance. Pseudo means false. Here pseudo means false and dominance means dominant part. So false dominant, like for example, like suppose this is a heterozygous condition in which one is capital letter and one is small letter. So basically normally capital A letter will dominate itself, but in this condition small letter will dominant. So recessive is dominant in this condition, that's why it is known as pseudo dominance, false dominance. So example here is hemophilia and red color blindness. So pseudo dominance, example is hemophilia and red color blindness. Okay, after that we have genotype and phenotype. Genotype means genetic makeup, genetic material, and phenotype means expression of a gene. So in questions it may be asked that what is the, which one of the following is the expression of a gene. So expression of a gene is phenotype, not the genotype. And genotype is genetic makeup and phenotype is expression of a gene. After that we have types of chromosomes. So for this we have a trick, like M set, M for metacentric, S for submetacentric, and A for acrocentric, and T for telocentric. So metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, and telocentric. Suppose this is a chromosome in which the centromere is at the center, means both are of equal size, so it is of metacentric. It is metacentric. Centromere is at center. So M for metacentric. Submetacentric means MC centromere is away from the centers, little bit away from center, not in the middle. If it is at the center, then it is metacentric. So here it is away from the center, that's why it is submetacentric. And after that we have acrocentric. Acro means almost at the tip, but not at the tip. If it is present, centromere present at the tip, then it is known as telocentric. Telo means tip. T for tip, T for telocentric. So telocentric basically not in humans, it is not present in humans. So acrocentric, submetacentric, metacentric, M set, remember it, M set. metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric and telocentric. Now their examples, like metacentric examples were chromosome 1s. All chromosome 1 are of metacentric, means centromere is present at the center. Metacentric chromosome 1. In M set, M comes comes at the first place. So M set example is chromosome 1. So chromosome 1, M set, metacentric. After that we have submetacentric. So S for sub metacentric and X, S for X. So chromosome X is at submetacentric. And acrocentric, remember this very very importantly. So acrocentric example is chromosome Y. Acrocentric is chromosome Y. And remember these were these chromosome numbers 13, 14, 15, 21, 22 and 23 Y. chromosome, 23 Y chromosome, not X chromosome. So 13, 14, 15, 21, 22, 23. After that we have telocentric, which is not present in humans. So these were the types of chromosomes. So types of chromosomes were M set. M comes at the first place, so example is chromosome 1. S for sex, so X chromosome X. And A for acrocentric, so example were 13, 14, 15, 21, 22 and 23 Y part. And telocentric is not present in humans. After that we have karyotyping. So karyotyping basically is used for the study of chromosomes, and it is for the samples like amniocentesis. We are going to do karyotyping, CVS, chorionic villus sampling, blood like lymphocytes, skin fibroblast. So these were the samples which were taken by karyotyping: amniocentesis, chorionic villus sampling, blood lymphocytes and skin fibroblast. So in basically what we do in karyotyping, basically when we take the sample and we have to arrest it at the metaphase stage. So how we arrest it at metaphase stage? We can arrest it by giving adding colchicine in it. So colchicine, how we arrest at metaphase? So we arrest at metaphase by colchicine. So after that we are going to do fixation. After that we have to do fixation. So fixation is done by Carnoy fixative, and in this it is the mixture of methanol and glacial acetic acid. So basically remember it like that. Carnoy, C comes in the ABCD at third number and A comes at the first number. So the ratio is 3:1. So remember it, ratio is 3:1. So methanol glacial acetic acid, it is the Carnoy fixative. So how we can arrest at the metaphase? We can arrest it by colchicine, and after that we have to do the fixative. Fixative is done by Carnoy fixative, which is the mixture of methanol and glacial acetic acid, which were present in the 3:1 ratio. After fixation we are doing staining and banding, like Z banding, GIMSA stain. So this is about the karyotyping. Karyotyping is done for sampling like amniocentesis, CVS, chorionic villus sampling, blood lymphocytes and skin fibroblast. After that there is epigenetics. Epi means above, genetics means genetic. So it is basically a qualitative or functional. And functional, in this epigenetics the function of gene is altered, whether the function is decreased or the function of gene is increased. Function is decreased by DNA methylation, we can arrest it. So we can decrease function is by DNA methylation. So example of decreasing function is DNA methylation. Epi means above, genetics. So it is a qualitative and functional epigenetics. Example is DNA methylation, which is decreasing function of the gene. After that we have mutation. Mutation means sudden permanent change in DNA. So mutation is a permanent change. So mutation is sudden and permanent change in DNA. So in this, genome reads in triplet form. We have, as we already know that genomes were read in triplet form. So basically there are two type of mutation: point mutation and frame shift mutation. Point mutation and frame shift mutation. Point mutation means like this is a genome code which we read in the triplet form. So in this, what will happen? In this, one amino acid is replaced by another amino acid, means there is a point mutation. In presence of one amino acid, another amino acid takes place. So at one point, one nucleotide replaced by another amino nucleotide. So one nucleotide is replaced by another. So this is point mutation. And in frame shift mutation, total one frame is deleted. So one suppose this is a one amino acid which is deleted, and after that the total frame of the code is changed. Like suppose this is a 3-3 pairs, we are making genome in triplet form. So this is a genome in triplet forms. If there is one deletion, then total the frame is changed. Like this one will make one pair, then this will make pair, and so on. So deleted, frame shift. So frame will change. Remember it like that. Total frame will change, and there is no replacement there. And in point mutation, there is replacement of one amino acid. Okay. So the examples of point mutation. So point mutation include silence mutation, missense mutation, and nonsense mutation. Nonsense means no production. It is useless. So nonsense, no production. Example, thalassemia. So thalassemia is example of nonsense, no production. Missense means, example is sickle cell anemia. Like HBS is replaced by HBS. And silence mutation, there is no effect in human. So silence mutation, there is no effect in human. Missense mutation, sickle cell anemia. And nonsense mutation, thalassemia. After that, there is genetic disease. As we all know, genetic disease were like Mendelian disorders, non-Mendelian disorders, chromosomal disorders, and multifactorial. Chromosomal disorders were like chromosome number or chromosomal defect, and multifactorial. So in Mendelian disorder, we are going to read about the autosomal dominant, recessive, X-linked dominant, X-linked recessive, and Y-linked or polyandric type. And in non-Mendelian disorders, we have to read about the mitochondrial disease, trinucleotide repeat disorder, genomic imprinting, or gonadal mosaicism, or germline mosaicism. And in chromosomal disorder, chromosomal number defect and structure defect. And in multifactorial, there is genetic defect or environmental defect. Like example, diabetes mellitus, hypertension, cleft lip, congenital heart disease, or cleft palate. So it is from the outside, multifactorial, whether it is genetic defect or it is of environmental effect. Many factors, multifactorial means many factors can affect it, like diabetes mellitus, hypertension, cleft lip, congenital heart disease, and cleft palate. So let's start with Mendelian disorders. First with the autosomal dominant and autosomal recessive. So autosomal dominant is the first question is autosomal dominant is most common mode of inheritance. So most common mode of inheritance is autosomal dominant, and autosomal recessive is most common mode of inheritance for inborn error metabolism, means the onset of that disease is from the childhood. So autosomal dominant is overall most common mode of inheritance, and autosomal recessive is inborn most common mode of inheritance for inborn error of metabolism, means onset is childhood, and in this onset is adult or adolescence. We can remember it like this. A means autosomal dominant, AD autosomal dominant. So AD represents adolescence or adults. So autosomal dominant is most common mode of inheritance, and for inborn error of metabolism, autosomal recessive. And in autosomal recessive, there is complete 100% penetrance and expressibility. Means if it present, then penetrance and expressibility is 100%. And in autosomal dominant, it is incomplete penetrance and variable expressibility. Means different features will come from one generation to another generation. So it is variable, and it is completely 100% expressible, means same character is coming in every generation. That is autosomal recessive. And in autosomal dominant, it is variable. So in autosomal dominant, structural protein defects is there. Structural protein defect is there. And in autosomal recessive, defect in metabolic or enzyme deficiency. So autosomal recessive, examples were of metabolic or enzyme deficiency. And in autosomal dominant, structural protein defects were there. So autosomal dominant, dominant means it is present in every generation. And in autosomal recessive, generation will be skipped. So in basically autosomal recessive were carrier. So autosomal recessive are carrier because it is present in only homozygous condition. So they were basically carriers. And in autosomal dominant, all generations were affected. So now let's learn some examples of autosomal dominant. So autosomal dominance, I have one trick for it. Like he has a very dominant father. So this is our trick for autosomal dominant. And I already make video on Mendelian disorders. Now you can check in my checklist. So autosomal dominant, he has a very dominant father. So he H for hereditary spherocytosis. H for hereditary spherocytosis. Has for Huntington's disease. It is Huntington disease. A for autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease. B for von Willebrand disease. D is for nothing. O for osteogenesis imperfecta. Marfan syndrome. I is for nothing. Neurofibromatosis type 1 and type 2. A for achondroplasia. And T for tuberous sclerosis. And F for familial hypercholesterolemia and FAP. These were the examples of autosomal dominant. So once again, he has a very dominant father. H for hereditary spherocytosis, Huntington disease, autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, von Willebrand disease, osteogenesis imperfecta, Marfan syndrome, neurofibromatosis type 1, type 2, achondroplasia, tuberous sclerosis, FAP, familial hypercholesterolemia. I hope you remember it by this trick very easily. After that, we have Marfan syndrome. So M for Marfan syndrome. So let's learn about some point about Marfan syndrome. So Marfan syndrome, in this, it is the most common defect of skeletal abnormality. So basically Marfan syndrome, in this there is defect in chromosome number 15. Fibrillin 1 gene is defective. So on chromosome 15, fibrillin 1 gene is defective. And in this, elastin proteins were involved. So remember these three points very, very importantly. Marfan syndrome, defect in chromosome 15. Marfan syndrome, defect in fibrillin 1 gene. This question may be asked in previous year paper also. So it may ask in future also. So in Marfan syndrome, defect in chromosome 15, fibrillin 1 gene is defective, elastin proteins. So for Marfan syndrome, we have trick Marfan. So Marfan syndrome. M for mitral wave prolapse. So most common heart defect in this is mitral wave prolapse. A for aortic dissection. So most common death in Marfan syndrome is due to aortic dissection. Remember this point also. In Marfan syndrome, most common death is due to aortic dissection. And mitral wave prolapse is the most common heart defect. R for retinal detachment. F for freely movable joints. Most common thumb joint. As we see in this photo, thumb joint is freely movable joint. And the most common thumb joint is defect involved in this. A for arachnodactyly. N for 9 feet tall. The person is of 9 feet tall. Syndrome disease. So syndrome or disease. Disease means dislocation of lens. As I said, retinal detachment is also there, and dislocation of lens, and location of the lens will shift from the superior, and this is the temporal side. So superior temporal side. Ectopia lentis is of superior temporal. So dislocation of lens in Marfan syndrome is superior and temporal side. And it involves the 9 feet tall, arachnodactyly, freely movable joints, retinal detachment, aortic dissection, and mitral wave prolapse. This is of Marfan syndrome, and the three most important point, fibrillin 1 gene is defective in it on chromosome number 15, and elastin proteins were involved in it. And Marfan syndrome is a defect in skeletal abnormality. I hope this trick will also help you in remembrance of Marfan syndrome. Next one is autosomal recessive, and as I already told, it is a defective in metabolic disease or enzyme deficiency. So autosomal recessive is occur in metabolic diseases and enzyme deficiency. So for this, I have one trick also, autosomal recessive. Like for autosomal dominant, he has a dominant father. Marfan syndrome or disease. autosomal recessive iatric pasta chawal, or we can say past chawal. So pasta chawal, P for phenylketonuria, A for alkaptonuria, S for sickle cell anemia, and T for thalassemia. These two conditions were of blood, from the blood. So blood two conditions were sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. P for phenylketonuria, ketonuria, alkaptonuria. So nuria, nuria, both have nuria, nuria, phenylketonuria, alkaptonuria, and two blood conditions, sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. So now phenylketonuria is due to deficiency of phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme, and it will represent a mousty or musty odor urine will produce. Mousty or musty odor urine will produce. Phenylketonuria is deficiency of which enzyme? Phenylalanine hydroxylase deficiency. Remember it. And for alkaptonuria also, please remember it, that it is also due to defective of homogentisic acid oxidase deficiency. And it shows black color, and black color on the standing of urine. Like if we put urine in a tube and just did not do anything, just put it on a table, so it will show after some time it will show black color. So this is called urine black on standing. So homogentisic acid will show black color, alkaptonuria, in three conditions: in urine, in cartilage, and in nails. It shows black color in urine, in cartilage, and in nails. It shows black color. Alkaptonuria, deficiency of homogentisic acid oxidase deficiency. And for phenylketonuria, please remember it, phenylalanine hydroxylase deficiency. Mousty or musty odor urine will produce. As for sickle cell anemia, T for thalassemia. And chawal, C for cystic fibrosis. All the deficiency and all the inherited disease, metabolic disease, will come under the autosomal recessive. Remember this point, that all the metabolic disease and all the enzyme deficiency work comes under the example of autosomal recessive, like phenylketonuria, alkaptonuria, sickle cell anemia, and thalassemia. For chawal, we have like C for cystic fibrosis. It is also due to defect. C for cystic fibrosis, CFTR gene will involved into it. CFTR gene. H for hemochromatosis, hemo means in blood, chromatosis. A for alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, W for Wilson disease, A for adrenal hyperplasia, L for lysosomal and glycogen storage disease. All the lysosomal storage disorders are autosomal recessive except two. Please remember, this point is very, very important. All the lysosomal and glycogen storage disease were comes under the autosomal recessive, except the two, that those were the Fabry's disease and Hunter's disease, which comes under the X-linked recessive, Please remember this point, that all lysosomal and glycogen storage disease were comes under the autosomal recessive, except two, Hunter's and Fabry's disease, which were X-linked recessive. So this is about the autosomal recessive. So phenyl pasta chawal. After that, we have Tay-Sachs disease. In Tay-Sachs disease, it is also the autosomal recessive. So here T represents the Tay-Sachs disease, A for autosomal recessive. Now Y means present in young children. S means there is some disease related to the eye, that is cherry red spot. So cherry red spot is seen in the Tay-Sachs disease. Remember this, cherry red spot is seen in Tay-Sachs disease at macula of eye. And A for Ashkenazi Jews, C for CNS manifestation like ballooned neurons work come. H for hexosa minidase deficiency, and S for onion skinning is present. So Tay-Sachs disease, it is example of autosomal recessive. Remember this. And after that, T for Tay-Sachs, A for autosomal recessive, Y for young children, S for cherry red spot at macula of eye, A for Ashkenazi Jews, C for CNS problem like ballooned neurons, H for hexosa minidase deficiency. In this, the deficiency is of hexosa minidase deficiency, and O for onion skinning. these were the examples of Tay-Sachs disease. Like in this photo, we see a cherry red spot. This is the fundus, and this is the cherry red spot. And we see a onion skinning like this one. Onion skinning is present on electron microscope. Every picture which is black and white is of electron microscope. In which we see the onion skinning like a onion. And this is the ballooned neuron. Remember it. It looks like a peacock. Something we call, I don't remember it. So it shows a ballooned neurons. Ballooned neurons is seen in the Tay-Sachs disease. After Tay-Sachs, we have Niemann-Pick disease. All the enzyme deficiency work comes under the autosomal recessive. That's why I'm telling you everyone, all the autosomal recessive disease, like Niemann-Pick disease, it shows the zebra bodies because black and white stripes are present in it. As we see, black and white stripes were present. So this represents the Niemann-Pick disease. After that, we have a Gaucher's disease. For this, please remember the deficiency of the enzyme, that is glucocerebrosidase deficiency. And also in Gaucher cells, crumpled tissue paper is present. As we see here, these were the crumpled tissue paper. So crumpled tissue paper is seen in Gaucher's disease, and there is deficiency of glucocerebrosidase deficiency. Now let's, after that we have X-linked recessive. In X-linked recessive, so first I am giving you an example. Suppose this is a male and this is a female, and female is a heterozygous, and this one is a carrier female because it represents with a small heterozygous, so it is a carrier. So X-linked recessive, female is a carrier. After we doing this, we get disease male, carrier females. So females always were carrier in X-linked recessive. So female never get diseased, so males were diseased. In X-linked recessive, male were diseased and female are carrier. So in this, male have disease and females were carrier in X-linked recessive. So example for this also, we have trick for X-linked recessive, like Y's ABCDEFG. So W for Viscott-Ehlerdrich syndrome, A, B means hemophilia AB, C for color blindness and chronic granulomatous disease, CGD, chronic granulomatous disease, D for Duchenne muscular dystrophy, E is for nothing, and F for fragile X syndrome or Fabry's and Hunter's disease. As I told in autosomal recessive, that all the lysosomal disease work comes under the autosomal recessive except two. Those were the Fabry's and Hunter's disease, which were X-linked recessive. And in X-linked recessives, males carry the disease and females were carrier. So females never get disease in X-linked recessive. Only male gets diseased. And G for glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. So this is the trick for X-linked recessive, Y's ABCDEFG, Viscott-Ehlerdrich syndrome, hemophilia AB, colorblindness, chronic granulomatous disease, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, E is for nothing, F for Fabry's disease and Hunter's disease and fragile X syndrome, and G for glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. After that, we have X-linked dominant. In X-linked dominant, the example, just we have to remember two question about it, that the examples were vitamin D resistant rickets and Alport syndrome. As we know, Alport syndrome have all the Mendelian inheritance, like autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked recessive, X-linked dominant, all are present in the Alport syndrome, but the most common is X-linked dominant. So the most common is X-linked dominant. That's why I write it here in X-linked dominant, that Alport syndrome shows all the Mendelian inheritance, and the most common Mendelian inheritance which was shown by the Alport syndrome is X-linked dominant. So X-linked dominant. So these were two examples of X-linked dominant. First one is the vitamin D resistant rickets, and second one is the Alport syndrome. After that, we have Y-linked. Y-linked means holyandric. Andro means androgen. Androgen means male-to-male transmission is there in Y-linked. So andro means androgenic. So the examples were hairy ears and hypertrichosis, means excess of hair is present in the ear. So this is the example of Y-linked hypertrichosis, and transmission is between, transfer is from male to male. Now we are going to learn about the non-Mendelian disorders. In non-Mendelian disorders, first one is the mitochondrial disease. In mitochondrial disease means M for mitochondria and M for maternal inheritance. So in this, maternal inheritance is present. Mitochondrial DNA, maternal inheritance. So basically, in this, the from the mother or from the female, disease is transferred to everyone, but not, it is not transferred from father or male to none. So mitochondrial disease, mother female to all and father male to none. Suppose this is a female which has disease, and this is normal male. After the in the first generation, all the females were carrying disease and all the males were carrying disease, because from mother or female, the disease will get to all generations. So from mother or female to all, as we see, all generation have disease. And from the from the female, the disease will transfer to the both male child. So from mother, it will get to both female child, and from this also, but none from this means father male to none. As we seen here, this is the father and male. After their mating, in their first generation, none of them will get disease. So mitochondrial disease is never transferred from father or male to anyone, and it is only transferred from mother female to all. So this is the example of mitochondrial disease. So let's learn about the examples like MELAS, CPO, all the letters which were come in questions, they were carried from the mitochondrial disease. So MELAS means mitochondrial encephalopathy, lactic acidosis, stroke like episodes. So MELAS, mitochondrial encephalopathy, lactic acidosis, stroke like episodes. CPEO, chronic progressive external ophthalmoplegia. Progressive external ophthalmoplegia, NARP and LHON. So these were the examples of mitochondrial disease. Mitochondrial disease, MELAS, CPEO, NARP, LHON. Now after that, we have the second non-Mendelian disorder, that is trinucleotide repeat disorder. In this, there is repeat of trinucleotide sequence like CGG or CAG. So it has two parts, non-coding and coding region. As we know, non-coding region is intron and coding region is of exon. So in exon, the examples were Huntington disease and Canidae disease. And in non-coding region, Fragile X syndrome and Friedreich ataxia. In Fragile X syndrome, CGG nucleotide repeat is there, and in Huntington, CAG nucleotide repeat is there. So let's learn about few points about the Fragile X syndrome. So Fragile X syndrome, repeat is of CGG, and in Huntington disease, CAG. So Fragile X syndrome is present on chromosome X. Q means long arm, so it is defect in the chromosome long arms, chromosome X, Q. And FMR1 gene is involved. Locus is FMR1 gene of chromosome XQ. So this is the P and this is Q. So defect is in the Q part of the chromosome X on which gene? FMR1 gene. Remember it, FMR1 gene. So if there is repeat, if there is less than 55 repeat is there, then it is normal. And if it is between 55 to 200, then pre-mutation is there. And if it is more than 200, like 200 to 400, then it is full mutation. So example of full mutation is Fragile X syndrome. And example of pre-mutation is Fragile X tremor or ataxia. So Fragile X ataxia or Fragile tremor. And we have one point that Sherman's paradox or anticipation means the repeat is increasing with each passing generation. Suppose in first generation, 55 repeat were there. So in second generation, the repeats were increasing, like it may be 100, 200. So this is Sherman's paradox. This is known as Sherman's paradox, or we can say anticipation. So anticipation is example of trinucleotide sequence repeat. Trinucleotide sequence repeat. Trinucleotide repeat disorder example is anticipation or Sherman's paradox. After that, we have some clinical features of trinucleotide sequence repeat, like it is the second most common cause of mental retardation. First most common cause of mental retardation is Down syndrome. Remember this also. So the most common cause of mental retardation is Down syndrome, and second most common is trinucleotide repeat disorder. In this, the person has the long face, long ears, and long mandible. Remember these three: face, ear, and mandible, not the nose. I said face, ears, and mandible is long. And macroorchidism is present, means the large testes were seen in the trinucleotide sequence disorder. And diagnosis be done by Southern blotting or PCR. Southern blotting and PCR is done in this. So I have one trick for sorry for that. Like in Southern blotting, south mostly people were eat dosa, so DNA, north roti, RNA, R for roti, R for RNA. In Western blotting, means in Western states, pizza were eaten mostly by the people, so P for pizza, P for protein. So south dosa means DNA, north roti means RNA, west pizza means protein. So in the trinucleotide disorder, southern blotting is done and PCR is done for diagnosis. And in, so till now we remember that on chromosome 15 defect there were three diseases, like Marfan syndrome, Prader-Willi syndrome, and Angelman syndrome. These three were the examples of defect in chromosome number 15: Marfan, Prader-Willi, and Angelman syndrome. Now next one is the genomic imprinting. Imprinting means silencing. Genomic means genes. So how we can do silencing? By DNA methylation, by doing DNA methylation. So here the example were Prader-Willi syndrome and Angelman syndrome. Both were present on the chromosome 15 defect. So basically in silencing, we have both maternal and paternal chromosomes were present there. So there is silencing of one gene and there is deletion of other one. So maternal gene is imprinting, means maternal gene gets the silent, maternal gene gets silent, and paternal gene gets deleted. So this is the defect in the Prader-Willi syndrome. P for paternal means paternal gene deleted, paternal chromosome deleted. Angelman, angel is like mother, mothers were angels. So in maternal gene is deleted in Angelman syndrome, and paternal is imprinting. So this is P, Prader means papa, region gets deleted. Angelman, maternal region gets deleted. So in Prader-Willi syndrome, short stature is present and obesity is present because there is increase in ghrelin hormone, which increases the appetite. So ghrelin is increasing, so that's why obesity is present in Prader-Willi syndrome and the person is of short stature. Angelman, for Angelman we have to remember the sari, like mother wears the sari. So Angelman, angel wears the sari. S for seizure, A for ataxia, R for mental retardation, I for inappropriate laughter. We also call Angelman syndrome like happy puppets. So Angelman syndrome were happy puppets because they inappropriately laugh. So sari for Angelman. After that we have gonadal mosaicism, gonadal or germline mosaicism. So in this, basically a child born with a genetic disease, if the grandparents and parents were normal, so if grandparents and parents were normal, still then child born with a genetic disease. This is a germline mosaicism or gonadal mosaicism, because in this there is post-zygotic mutation will occur. Post-zygotic mutation will occur in germline or gonadal mosaicism. So examples were osteogenesis imperfecta and tuberous sclerosis. So tuberous sclerosis and osteogenesis imperfecta were example of gonadal mosaicism or germline mosaicism. After that, now it's finished about the totally finish of Mendelian and non-Mendelian disorder. After that we have chromosomal disorders. So in chromosomal disorders we have structural defect and chromosome number defect. First we learn about the structural defect. In structural defect we have deletions. So deletion, like Reidu-Chat syndrome, there is deletion of 5p. And inversion here, suppose there is inversion of it. So inversion 16, example is inversion 16, AMLM4. After that we have translocation. So we have translocation like Philadelphia chromosome in chronic myelogenous leukemia, translocation from 9 to 22, BCR-ABL fusion. So remember it, So there is two type of translocation, balanced and unbalanced translocation. In balanced translocation, if one gene is from this chromosome went to this chromosome, then this chromosome gene is present into this. This is balanced, means they are giving and taking one gene, they are replacing one gene with each other. And in unbalanced translocation, there is only shifting of one gene from this to this chromosome, but there is no replacement is going to be done here. No replacement is going to be done here. So example is like ABL-PCR fusion is occurring in unbalanced translocation. Example is Philadelphia chromosome, which is shown, which is seen in chronic myelogenous leukemia. Translocation of 9 to 22 BCR ABL fusion. After that, we have in this translocation, we have Robertsonian translocation. For Robertsonian translocation, we have to remember about the acrocentric chromosome. As I already told in the M set, like A for acrocentric, and A is present in the 13, 14, 15, 21, 22, 23, and Y. 23, Y. So if there is translocation between these acrocentric chromosome, then it is Robertsonian translocation, then it is known as Robertsonian translocation. Like 14 and 22 both were present in the acrocentric chromosome, so it is known as Robertsonian translocation. After that, we have a ring chromosome. Ring chromosome is seen in the Turner syndrome. Remember it, ring chromosome is seen in Turner syndrome, in which ends were damaged and ends of the chromosomes were get damaged. So it is example of ring chromosome is Turner syndrome. After that, we have isochromosome. Iso means same arms, two, like 2p or 2q is present. So normally in one chromosome we have one short arm and one long arm, but if both the arms were short or both the arms were long, then it is known as isochromosome, like 2p or 2q. Normally there is plane of division is the longitudinal. Normally the plane of division is longitudinal. If the plane of division is transversal, if the plane of division is transversal, then we get both the, whether we get both arms were small or both arms were long. So it is isochromosome, 2p or 2q. So most common isochromosomes were like IXQ, and most common tumor associated with testicular tumor is I12P. So IXQ and I12P. Now after that, we have a numerical chromosomal defect. So in this, we have to study about Down, Turner, Patau, Edward, Klinefelter, Cat-Cry syndrome, Cat-Eye syndrome, Noonan syndrome, or EDS. So let's start with the Down syndrome. So Down syndrome is most common chromosomal disorder. So most common chromosomal disorder is Down syndrome, as it shows the most common mental retardation. First most common mental retardation is shown in Down syndrome. So it is due to trisomy 21. So trisomy 21 will occur in the Down syndrome. So pathogenesis were like meiotic non-disjunction of chromosome 21 in ova. So remember this point, there is meiotic non-disjunction of chromosome 21 in ova. It is associated with advanced maternal age. So it is associated with advanced maternal age. And the second pathogenesis is, it is also seen in 4% Robertsonian translocation, 4% Robertsonian translocation, between the acrocentric chromosomes, and it is not associated with maternal age. So advanced maternal age association is with non-disjunction of chromosome 21 in ova. So clinical features were in Down syndrome is like most common cause of mental retardation, as it is most common cause of mental retardation. Mongoloid faces means oblique palpable fissure is seen. As we see, the eyebrows were little slanted. Oblique palpable fissure, and there is flat nose is present. Flat nose is present. So nasal bone hypoplasia. As we see at this place, the bone is flat. Nasal bone is flat. So nasal bone hypoplasia. Oblique palpebral fissure is present, so it shows the mongoloid facies. Open mouth is present, as we see in both the pictures that the mouth is open because of macroglossia, means the tongue is bigger in size. So macroglossia is seen in Down syndrome. Eyes we have seen the brush filled spot. Remember it, it's most important that brush filled spot is seen in the Down syndrome. As for Simenian crease, normally in the pupils we have two two lining is present here, but in the Down syndrome we have only one Simon crease is present as seen in this picture. So simian single palmar crease is seen. And as for sandal toe, there is a big difference between the first toe and the second. So sandal toe is present. So the complication of Down syndrome is like leukemia. Overall, most common leukemia is ALL. And if the child is of less than 2 years and of the Down syndrome, then AMLM7 is seen. Remember this question also, AMLM7 is associated with the Down syndrome. It is the most common complication. So AMLM7 leukemia. After leukemia, we have a heart defect also in this. Complication of heart is endocardial cushion defect. Remember this also, endocardial cushion defect. In the CNS, we have premature Alzheimer's disease, which is between the age of 20 to 30 years. Premature Alzheimer's disease. And the GIT complication is like duodenal atresia. It is the most common atresia overall. So duodenal atresia, annular pancreas, and Hirschsprung disease. Now the screening test which is done for Down syndrome, like triple test or quadruple test. In triple test, we have estriol, AFP, alpha fetoprotein, and beta HCG, H4 high. So in increase in HCG, and both these were estriol and alpha fetoprotein were decreased. And in quadruple test, we have one more including it, inhibin A. In this also H will come, so it is also increasing. So alpha fetoprotein, beta HCG, and inhibin A, these both were suspect the Down syndrome, and we can confirm it by doing karyotyping. So there is one trick I had for the Down syndrome, like what is the problem in Down syndrome. So AC is the problem in Down syndrome. AC is the problem. A for AML, Alzheimer's disease or atresia. Most common atresia is duodenal atresia. Okay. Now C for congenital heart disease, that is endocardial cushion defect. Endocardial cushion defect. Basically, in endocardial cushion defect, we have atrioventricular septal defect. I for intellectual disability means mental retardation. S for simian crease and central defect is seen. T for tumor, like ALLM7, or if the child is less than 2 years, then AMLM7 is seen. P for protruding tongue means hypoglossia or macroglossia. Macroglossia, enlargement. Macroglossia, enlargement. Is there R for round face, O for open mouth, open wide fontanelle is present. B for brachycephaly or brush filled spot is seen in the eye, means white dots is seen in the iris part. L for low nasal bridge. E for epicanthal folds were seen or low satias were seen in it. And M for mongoloid slant. After that, we have Patau and Edward syndrome. Patau means trisomy 13 and Edward means E for Edward, E for 18. So E for Edward and E for 18. Trisomy 18 is seen in Edward syndrome. Patau syndrome, we have trisomy 13. So some features were common for both Patau syndrome and Edward syndrome. Those were like mental retardation is present in both. Patent ductus arteriosus is also seen in both Patau and Edward. And Drucker bottom foot is also present in both Patau and Edward syndrome. So in Patau syndrome, we have polydactyly, cleft palate, cleft lip, and coloboma is seen, like a keyhole is seen in the eye. So these were the Patau syndrome, polydactyly, cleft lip, cleft palate, coloboma. And if you want to learn more about the Pout syndrome, then please watch my playlist. In that we have, I already told, explain about the Patau syndrome. And for 18 means Edward syndrome, the occiput is prominent. As we see, occiput is prominent. Overlapping fingers were present as seen here. And the kidney is horseshoe shaped kidney. Kidneys of horseshoe shaped kidney. As we see here, rocker bottom foot is present. Patent ductus arteriosus is seen, congenital heart defect, and horseshoe shaped kidneys were seen in the Edward syndrome. So this is about the Edward syndrome. Now we have cat eye syndrome. In cat eye syndrome, chromosome 20, there is trisomy 21. Cat eye syndrome, trisomy 21. And cat cry syndrome. Cat cry means cry do chat syndrome. There is deletion of 5p chromosome. After that, we have Klinefelter syndrome. In Klinefelter syndrome means there is one extra X chromosome is present. Normally, 46XY is present in a male. If there is one extra X, means the male will represent some female characters because extra X is present, going to present in it. So, like 47XXY or 48XXY. So, extra X is of maternal or either it can be of paternal. But more commonly it is of maternal. So, more X chromosome, more mental retardation is going there. So, as there is more X chromosome, so more mental retardation is present. So, the clinical features of Klinefelter syndrome is, like as I said, the male will represent, going to represent some female character. So, hypogonadism is present in the male. So, hypogonadism is present. There is mental retardation and there is decrease of secondary sexual characters. So, the complication were, like, most common cancer is male breast cancer is going to occur, and second most common is extragonadal germ cell tumor is present. In heart defect, we have mitral wave prolapse. So, mitral wave prolapse is seen in Klinefelter syndrome. Patent ductus arteriosus is seen in Patau syndrome and 18 Edwards syndrome. So, autoimmune disease is going to seen like SLEs, systemic lupus erythematosus, and hormone profile is going to change. Like, there is decrease of testosterone because female characters were increasing. So, FSH and LH is going to increase in it. Klinefelter syndrome. After that, we have the Turner syndrome. So, Turner syndrome, there is deletion of one X chromosome. So, 45XO means the female is going to represent some male characters because there is absence of one X chromosome. So, one X chromosome is going to be deleted. Or we can say in Turner syndrome, as I already told, there is a ring chromosome is going to represent. So, 46XR, R4 ring. So, in Turner syndrome, it is the most common cause of primary amenorrhea. So, the most common cause of primary amenorrhea is Turner syndrome and secondary amenorrhea is pregnancy. Secondary is pregnancy and primary is Turner syndrome. So, the clinical feature of Turner syndrome is like short stature, webbing of neck, and there is cystic hygroma on the neck, like lymphangioma is seen, and low post hairline is seen. And there is widely spaced nipples is present in Turner syndrome because female is going to represent the male characters. That's why widely spaced nipple is there. And bicuspid aortic valve defect is seen, or we can say coarctation of aorta, and streak ovary underdevelopment is seen in Turner syndrome. In the Noonan syndrome, it is opposite, that like in Turner syndrome, female is going to represent the male, and in Noonan syndrome, male counterpart of Turner syndrome. So it in this, there is mutation in chromosome number 12, and in Turner syndrome, there is deletion of one X chromosome, like 45XO. But in Noonan syndrome, there is mutation in chromosome number 12. After that, we have one question, like normal karyotype is arranged in a descending order of the length. So, one chromosome is of largest, but the shortest chromosome is chromosome number 12. Remember this point, shortest chromosome is chromosome number 21. Shortest chromosome is chromosome number 21. So, after that, we have a Lorentz hypothesis. In Lorentz hypothesis, suppose this is 46XX'. So, X is of active part and X is of inactive part. So, this inactive X is Lorentz hypothesis, means inactive X chromosome is known as bar body. So, how we can calculate the bar body? So, number of bar body is going to calculate by number of X minus 1. So, this is the formula, number of X minus 1. And in the inactivations, so this inactivation, see, this inactive X is random selection. Either it can be maternal or paternal. It is a random selection. It is not selected. So it is random selection. And it is occur on the day 5.5 of the embryo. Day 5.5 of embryo. And gene which include is ZIST gene. So ZIST gene is include in the Lorentz hypothesis. And inactivation is due to DNA methylation. So, inactivation is due to DNA methylation. So, here I am going to give example of bar body, how we calculate it. Suppose this is 46XX. So, there are number of X chromosome were 2. So, from the 2 minus 1 means number of X minus 1. So number of axes were 2. So 2 minus 1, that is 1 bar body. 46xy, there is 1 x, number of x is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. In Klinefelter syndrome, we have triple x. So in triple x means 3 minus 1, that is 2 bar body is present. 2 inactive x is present in Klinefelter syndrome. So this is about the Lyons hypothesis. Now we have last, that is EDS, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. In Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, basically we call it rubber man syndrome. And in this, there is collagen defect. Most common collagen defect is type 3 collagen defect. And most common subtype of EDS is type 3. So most common type 3 collagen defect and most common EDS is type 3. And EDS is also known as cigarette paper skinning. It is also known as cigarette paper skinning. So this is all about the genetics. I hope you all get some information from this video. And if you want to give me some suggestion, then you're most welcome. I hope you enjoy it.